So this is our tomato patch. And when they say that a healthy plant is a happy plant, there's a lot to that statement when it comes to dealing with pests. Because this year, different from previous, from last year, was that we did not want to use pesticides anymore in dealing with aphids, whiteflies, and you name it, nematodes that have been attacking these plants in previous years. And what we did differently this year was focus a lot on the biology that happens in the root zone by way of inoculating with different bacteria and microbes, and feeding the microbes and feeding the bacteria. And what we've seen on these plants and all the other ones that are here did the same type of work, was that there were almost no pests. There's no white flies to be seen, which is amazing, or leaf miners, and that's pretty much attributed to the health of the plant. There's a lot of research out there that will show you why that is. So one of the ways that we measure a healthy plant is by doing sap analysis. Now, in the Philippines, we don't have accessible labs where we can just submit some leaf samples and then they can return us with a complete analysis on the nutritional content of leaf or leaf surfaces. So one of the tools that we use is a simple Brix meter, which is used just to, you know, for fruits, to measure the sweetness, and it you just put some sap or some fruit juice on here, and then close the lid, make sure there's no air pockets, air spaces, and then in here it'll give you a number, and the higher the number, the sweeter the fruit generally is. Now what you can also do is cut off some leaves like I did here and press it, so you press the liquid out. So either you use like this kitchen appliance, or if you want to do it manually, just wrap it around some plastic and then wring it with your hands. You only need a few drops here anyways. So I just measured this morning using this Brix meter and with these leaves, and the result was about 8% of Brix, which is just above the threshold of where aphid insects are attracted to the plant. And without having to use any pesticides or any other kind of chemical, these plants have been able to grow without the need for them. And that to us is really amazing, because none of us want to use pesticides. But by the time you reach for them, it's probably already too late. And those of us who've been using pesticides know that it's a losing battle. So you want to keep your plants healthy, and you want to get rid of the pests, which us as growers, we all want. The simpler solution is to work with the microbes and to work on plant health and to dose nutrition at the right levels to support the biology that happens in the media or in the root zone, in the rhizosphere. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and we're just sharing our experience to help make other people in the Philippines become better growers and rely less on the pesticide market or even the fertilizer markets. Be less reliant on them by understanding what makes plants healthy. And the next work we're going to be doing with these plants is on the hormonal level, the auxins and the cytokinins. And we'll be publishing a video about that really soon. Okay, thanks.